At last, you've arrived. Good, good. There is much to do, and every moment is critical. I'm Overseer Tremel. For decades, I've administered the trials that prove who is and is not worthy to join the Sith Order. The trials are a chance to weed out the weak. Those who face them either survive and become Sith, or die.
I won't disappoint you.
Good. I risked a lot to make this happen. Yes, you are here and ahead of schedule because of me. I expect you to obey. You face your trials, you serve me, and I will make you the most powerful acolyte here.
Why am I skeptical?
Have a critical edge, but recognize who is on your side. The trials themselves are difficult enough, but they are hardly the greatest threat you face. There's an acolyte here named Vemrin. He's your enemy, and he will try to kill you. We must prepare you.
Let him try. I'll destroy him.
With my guidance, someday you'll destroy all your enemies. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. The blade of lesser acolytes. You need a dominating weapon. In the tomb of Ajunta Paul, there's an old armory. A strong Sith warblade awaits you there. The tomb is thick with claw slugs. Deadly, savage creatures. Be speedy, but careful. They've been the end of many an acolyte.
If they lack the instinct to avoid me, I'll feed them their heads.
Once you acquire the warblade, I suggest you spend some time in the tomb bloodying it. Then come to me in my chambers in the academy.
Hey there, Acolyte. Hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you. So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
Are you saying I haven't earned my way?
Please, everyone knows what Tremel is doing. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, you might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill her and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Dulgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
My honor is not to be questioned.
We'll see about that. Coming, Dulgus.
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other. But accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
I hope it's thirsty. I plan on drowning it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my war blade, and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here. On her way to becoming Sith. If she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father. But I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her. She's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
He just introduced himself to me.
If he didn't attack, he must not fully comprehend the threat you represent. Good, good. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob?
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure should be good enough. Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse. You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate three prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
You'd better send someone to clean up after me.
The slave pens are right there. They have mops. Go to the Academy prison. Speak to head jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk. If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals, too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jailer Nash. I run these cells and slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
That's good to hear. I want to do well.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, at these three shipped in for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these three prisoners are being transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
Show me to these soon-to-be-dead lowlifes.
Fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me. Just do whatever you're gonna do.
You can either talk to me or to the Inquisitors, and I promise, I have a much sunnier disposition.
Get lost. I've been through this routine. I already know all your Inquisitors by name.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me.
So, you're telling me you're not a Republic assassin?
I'm not political. I work for whoever pays.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat. Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
You spared her. Interesting.
Please, I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Oh, you want to fight? You don't actually think you can beat me, do you?
This pile of waste is Davotech. Once a valued...
have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I don't do charity work. Feel the weight of a weapon in your throat.
I die a disgrace.
Good. I won't have to look at his sad, weathered face anymore. Thank you.
He won't have to look at yours either, Jailer.
Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebik.
Come on, who would go to all the trouble of setting you up?
Nibikat nakamak! Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamnalebik.
He's never wavered from that line. And the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I don't care if he's innocent or not. Torture him enough and he'll confess.
Shut up, you fidgety fool. The decision's been made. Well, that's that. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Your Overseer is eyeing you, Acolyte. You may want to see what he needs.
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solence. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Thank you, Overseer. I'm glad you approve.
What's more important is that Darth Barriss would approve. Now, Devotec, the former warrior. He wanted combat, but you struck him down. Perfect. The man was utterly useless.
I do not ever choose to waste my time.
Once something is used up, it should be eradicated. Lastly, the forger you sent back for more torture, even though he seemed innocent. A strong decision. Leave no stone unturned.
The ripple from even a tiny stone can flow a great distance.
Well, well. Look who just turned deep and insightful. It's always best to know beyond any doubt. After all, what is one man's sanity or life versus the fate of the Empire? Each time, each prisoner, you made the best possible decision. You may yet be able to challenge Vemrin for Darth Barriss's attention. To celebrate, a small reward.
Thank you very much, Overseer.
Thank yourself, Acolyte. It's performances like this that might just beat the extreme odds we're facing. Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally. Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
Sounds like a good opportunity for violence.
Hold nothing back. This creature is doom itself. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
A fresh young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you.
Your lab looks like the inside of a beast's belly.
So quick to turn away in disgust. You're denying yourself knowledge and power. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Your ego is overinflated.
I have gazed into the depths of the abyss and found revelations there others only dream of. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
The galaxy is a harsh place.
You don't understand. I've lost a vital key to unlocking the dark side's true essence. You acolytes delve those tombs on your trials. You could hunt that Tukata for me and retrieve its perfect brain. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
Why not send your apprentice to recover this beast?
She's more suited to the laboratory than the tombs. She lacks your fire, I'm afraid. Ask Melora where to seek the Tukata and return to me when you have its brain.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
Tell me how you know this.
My master is insane. Wasn't it obvious when you spoke to him? Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
You're just scheming to get rid of your master.
I have a greater destiny than serving as a research assistant in this pathetic excuse for a laboratory. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I'll see if the mood strikes me.
You'll earn rewards from both the Master and his apprentice. It's a better deal. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnost. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Have you recovered the mutant Tukata brain yet? I'm eager to conclude the business we discussed.
It's all yours. Enjoy.
Excellent. This chemical will make it appear as though Renning is falsifying his research. There.
All that remains is for me to whisper the right words in the wrong ears. I'm transferring credits to your account now. Give Renning the brain and collect his reward, too. You've made out quite well.
Pray this doesn't come back to haunt me.
Save your tiresome threats. I'll take care of everything. We shouldn't be seen speaking again. Lord Renning might suspect us. Give him the brain.
You have the brain at last. Excellent work. I trust it wasn't too much trouble.
I punished the foul creature for the trouble it caused you.
My apprentice, Melora, could learn from your example. She's much too soft-hearted. I must continue my research at once. Great discoveries await. Take a reward and go.
You might want to consider bathing sometime.
Yes, yes, you may stop talking now. Goodbye.
Well, look who's here. Remember me?
I never forget a face. Your name is Dolgis, right? Vemrin's boy.
Very good. It's good to know the name of your killer. Notice anything interesting? No witnesses. No witnesses means no rules. No more shortcuts, no more special treatment. You're just gonna be another dead failure on Korriban.
Hold up. Look, I was wrong. What they're saying about you, totally true. So, strong. I don't want to die.
Ask for no mercy and expect none. Die like a Sith.
I failed you, Vemrin.
We must speak quickly, Acolyte. There isn't much time. I may have made a slight miscalculation. The beast of Mark Aragnos was a great source of dark energy here on Korriban. When it was slain, there was a tremor in the Force.
Darth Barriss felt that tremor and has become aware of you. He demands an audience.
Tell me what to expect, Overseer.
Barriss is a serious man, but a master of deception. Everything he does and says is calculated.
He will attempt to trip you up, test your nature, get to the heart of who you are. Always take him seriously. And I mean, always.
Consider me warned.
We might not speak again, Acolyte. You're the best chance of stopping Vemrin. If you fail, I doubt there will be another strong enough. Good luck.
Meet Darth Barriss in his chambers, and hurry. He won't take kindly to waiting.
I believe that's the one.
Really? All right. Hey, you!
Careful, Tino.
Come on, I'm antsy for some action. You there? Are you the big shot they're all talking about? The one who's been personally summoned by Darth Barriss himself?
News sure does travel fast.
Please pardon my over-eager friend. It's just that we've heard so much about you.
And we want to get in good with you.
Tino? What my blunt partner here means is that if you need anything or anyone, say, dealt with, we'd like you to consider us.
She's talking about Vemrin. We'll kill him for you.
Sorry. I should have had Tino muzzled. So, what do you say? We know Vemrin tried to have you killed. Would you like him eliminated?
I'm preserving the pleasure for myself.
Far be it for us to rob you of such an experience, but consider this. There are rules. Acolytes are not to openly kill one another. Everyone knows of your rivalry. If you kill him, the Lords will presume your guilt.
But if Vemrin croaks while you get an alibi, people might be suspicious, but they won't be able to pin it on you. See?
I wouldn't be upset if Vemrin turns up dead.
Say no more. Go about your business. We'll handle this with utter discretion.
What does this mean, Fine?
It means Vemrin is a dead man, and we're going to have the most potent of allies.
most of you will not return from this endeavor. If you die, you will be forgotten. If you give up, you will be killed. No, out of my sight.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You should. This is the end of the line for you, Clemeral. Just make sure you stay out of my way.
Look here, Vimran. I see the upstart, but no sign of Douglas.
Clemeral, Vimran, you have been dismissed.
Yes, Master.
I underestimated you by sending Douglas. It will not happen again.
Are you having trouble with Acolyte Vimran, Supplicant?
If he insists on getting in my face like that, he's going to have trouble with me.
He has been hardened into a lethal machine. Vimran has paid his dues. He's fought a deck stacked against him to get here. You, on the other hand... Let me get a closer look at you. Yes, as I suspected. Overseer Tremel has done you and this academy a great disservice. Your warblade came early. Prisoners flown in for your convenience. Even a beast here on Korriban instead of off-world in the wild. The pacing of the trials is deliberate. Only full immersion over time produces results. Your mind is soft, unhoned, undisciplined.
I'll remember that. And someday you'll regret those words.
I wouldn't regret destroying you where you stand. The first month of trials should be dedicated to philosophy, conceptual tactics, understanding of the Sith Code. Recite the Sith Code for me, Acolyte, and explain its meaning in battle, war, and politics.
I don't recall learning a Sith Code, my lord.
Your ability is undeniable. But your readiness and your understanding of the Sith way is woefully lacking. I am your master now. Tremel was becoming lax before you ever arrived. His unwillingness to adapt to the evolving Sith paradigm has become a liability. These are the actions of a traitor. Traitors are executed. I grant you immunity from punishment. Kill Tremel. And bring back his hand as proof.
I do not like the idea of killing him, but I'll do it if I must.
I do not make requests, Supplicant. Now, leave. I'm sure Tremel is still in his chambers. Don't return until you've killed him.
I didn't expect to see you again so soon. Has Barriss sent you back to me?
Your instincts are sharp, Overseer. Barriss ordered me to kill you.
Then I have been outplayed. Barriss has the authority, but I did not think he would do something this overt. Either I die, or he forces me to kill you, and to destroy my own plan. A masterstroke. Very well, you have your orders, Acolyte. Know that it gives me no pleasure to kill you.
Hold on. It doesn't have to come to this, Tremel.
Do not hedge now. This is the way of the Sith. I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do. Now, I'm amazed. I knew you were strong in the Force, but not like this.
You're more than ready to challenge Vimran. Barriss won't be able to deny that now.
He'll have the satisfaction of my death. But I die knowing my success. Go ahead. End this.
You're getting ahead of yourself. I only need your hand.
What? Wait. I think I understand. Barriss demands my hand. Proof of my death. I don't want your pity, Acolyte.
That's the deal. Take it or leave it.
I'm a credit to the dark side. My cause is just. You can see clearly, even if Barriss cannot.
Take my hand.
Well, that didn't tickle. I'll rest and then leave Corriban covertly.
The outcome was most unfortunate.
Agreed. But as long as you live, there is hope. Cast Vemrin out, and the final triumph will be ours. Goodbye.
What's this? The Acolyte returns, and with a bloodied weapon. I assume this means Tremel is no more. Give me his hand. Here, take this one ring as a memento. Remembering the past can strengthen resolve and embolden the spirit. I am impressed you had the fortitude to destroy him. You know he thought of you as family. How did it feel to betray him?
I did what was called for.
You mask your feelings well, as long as you don't suppress them. You have taken your first step to understanding the Sith Code. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, we gain strength. Through strength, we gain power. Through power, we gain victory, and through victory, our chains are broken. The Force shall set us free. By embracing the code and destroying Tremel, you have freed yourself from his shackles and escaped his fate.
And now I'm bound by your shackles.
You'll find they are a marked improvement, with much greater potential range. Now, there are sacred ruins in the tomb of Tulak Horde. The ancient inscriptions that once adorned the walls of each ruin lie in pieces. You will venture through the entire tomb, search all of the ruins, and bring me a shard from each of these inscriptions. You will do this, or you will die. Vemrin and my other acolytes have already been sent. There are no rules regarding how they secure the shards, and they will stop at nothing. Fight your way through the tomb of Tulak Horde in the Valley of the Dark Lords, and bring me the shards from each of the ruined shrines.
I have need of you, young one. Whatever errand your master sent you on can wait until we are through.
As you decree, my lord.
I am Inquisitor Urinth, and I represent the intelligence operations of the Sith. We are currently holding an important Jedi prisoner, a spy who attempted to reach this academy. We have plans for him. Upon capture, we found the Jedi's mind simple to manipulate. We fed him false memories through a combination of drugs and sorcery. Soon he will return to his Jedi commanders and report the lies we fed him. He will know nothing of what we've done. All that remains is to stage his escape.
How are you going to pull that off?
You are young enough, new enough, to be a plausible traitor. You will go to the Jedi, talk to him, do as he asks, earn his trust. When that is done, set him free. Do whatever is necessary to get him out of prison. We will ensure that he reaches his ship and returns safely to his Jedi friends.
How do I know you won't accuse me of treason?
Prove your strength. Prove that you are truly Sith, and all the accusations in the world will mean nothing. You will find the Jedi Quarian Dorjus in the jail cells. He is still confused, and should not be overly difficult to convince.
There is no emotion. There is peace. There is no ignorance. There is knowledge. The Jedi Code will guide me.
I take it you're the Jedi who was captured.
I'm Quarian Dorjus. I'm a Jedi. Even here. Even on Korriban. Why do you care? Why are you here?
I'm here to get you home, if you play your cards right.
And I'm to trust you, the word of a Sith. I don't understand. You're here to help me. Why am I talking in circles? What's wrong with me?
You need to calm down.
You're right. I apologize. There's no passion. There's serenity. There's no chaos. There's harmony. The Jedi Code will guide me. I can focus. If you want to help me escape, I'll need my belongings, my lightsaber, my comlink. Before I was captured, the Sith chased me into the tomb of Tulak Horde. I hid my belongings inside an urn to lighten my load. That is where you'll need to go. I know you. We talked before. My head's clearer now, Sith. It's all here. The comlink, my lightsaber, everything I hid. You're going through with it. With all this, once the guards change shifts, I think I can slip out of the academy. But what about you? Will you be okay?
Me? I'll be fine. I'm more worried about you.
That's very kind of you, Sith. I still don't understand why you're doing this, but I thank you.
I think it's time that I be going.
As you say, Sith. Thank you again. I'm sorry the Empire took you in instead of the Jedi. If things had been different, maybe you could have been part of the Order.
So the Jedi is preparing his escape. You did well. Not perfectly, but I have confidence the operation will succeed. Our business is concluded. I will make note of your assistance in my report.
I don't need your praise.
No, I imagine you don't. Take these tokens as payment for your service, and know that no Jedi can threaten Korriban. Now go.
You did it, didn't you? You got the shards from the tomb, and you're on your way back to Lord Barriss.
Are you here to congratulate me?
I'll take that as a yes.
Stop! I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I tried to get through the tomb, but there were just too many Shyrak. I barely escaped. I figured better to ambush you and take your shards. But I see that's just as futile. Vemran is already inside with Barriss. All the other acolytes died. You were my only chance. Now, I'm doomed. I'll never become Sith. Unless I return with the shards, Barriss will have me killed.
Why don't you flee? Get off the planet. Give up trying to be Sith.
You can't get off Korriban without official clearance. I might be able to hide in the wilds, but I wouldn't survive long.
Then be a man and try to get the shards again.
I can't go back in there. I just can't. I've heard of a mad hermit in one of the tombs who welcomes failures from the trials. Maybe I'll seek him out.
Supplicant returns, and with all the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde. Superb. It seems your hopes have been dashed, Vemran.
Appearances can be deceptive.
Excuse Vemran, Supplicant. He didn't take kindly to turning those young acolytes on him, even though they were only untrained novices.
That was a trick I learned from Vemran himself. I was just giving him a taste of his own medicine.
The tension is thick between you two. A great source of emotion to feed on. I wonder what will happen when it boils over. You both stand on the precipice of becoming Sith. But only one of you will have the opportunity to claim a special lightsaber and serve as my apprentice. I thought it would be you, Vemran, but I've changed my mind.
What? I've done everything you've asked. Better than any of the others. The honor should be mine.
This is as it should be. Get used to being in my shadow.
Today, Vemran is every bit your equal. But the Force is stronger with you, Acolyte. There is a power sleeping within you. It was a simple decision. Now, Vemran, go wait in my antechamber for your instructions. This instant. Now I hope you fathom how fortunate you are to be singled out. If you become my apprentice, the galaxy will bend before you.
You're not going to regret this, Barriss. I was born to be Sith.
The lightsaber you will seek is old and powerful. It is housed in a forbidden cavern in the tomb of Nargasadao, where few Sith have ever set foot. Almost no one knows how to find the secret entrance. But there is a Twi'lek in the holding pens who was caught breaking in there. I hear she is quite willful. Take her and make her show you the entrance to the forbidden cave.
You insult me, Barriss. I do not need the help of a slave.
You will not find the forbidden cave without her. Other acolytes seeking to complete their trials are sent to the tomb, where Academy laws are waived. They will try to murder you. This test will determine if you become Sith. So bolster yourself. To set foot in the tomb of Nargasadao is to breathe in death itself.